Hi, my name is Sarah and welcome to my ePortfolio. The very first medium of art I decided to proceed with was music. I chose the piano as my learning mechanism to see how it will develop my memory and attention span. I downloaded the piano app in replacement of a keyboard. This is a great resource to obtain within a classroom. It gives students the opportunity to get in touch with technology, giving them the chance and the availability to play anywhere and anytime after school hours when they can not access a keyboard or any other instruments. This further displays my involvement with the Professional Learning Standard 3.4. For a first attempt, I decided to play any song so that I was more comfortable with the instrument and immune to the sound that it was creating. This, however, was very challenging for me due to the fact that I had never played before or had a prior knowledge of knowing or how to read the notes. After my tutorial class, I was able to understand clearly what every note displayed, which made it tremendously easier to play and enjoy. As an educator, it is vital that I implement and encourage my students to experiment with musical compositions to allow them to become innovative thinkers and producers as well as independent learners. Initially, as Christmas is on its way, I decided to play an all-time favorite jingle bell in the form of a resource. I had printed the music sheet in order to guide me through the notes, and I also filled in by allocating the correct letters for each note. Through the patience and eagerness of trying to grasp the techniques behind playing the piano, I came to a sense that with practice, I slowly developed a small growth and experience. With that being said, as an educator, I must create an encouraging classroom environment that will promote confidence and motivation to learn at any pace and practice. This is further reinforced in the Australian syllabus as it suggests that the notion of practicing music is a fundamental element that improves a student's attention span as well as engagement level in class. The next medium of art I chose was dance. I decided to focus upon hip hop. To understand the dance moves that are associated with hip hop, I turned to YouTube videos as a step-by-step guide. Students are able to increase their memory skills and spatial movement by conducting different moves in which will further develop their understanding around routines and allow them to construct their own. However, along my journey of dance, I realized that it was difficult for me to coordinate the moves that I was following up and decided that creative arts has no wrong or right moves or certain traditional structure. It is what you express and construct. Through this, I decided to go to what was trending by the wider public and do the Kiki challenge moves, in which was a set of moves that was altered in accordance to your own performance and your own way of moving your body when doing the set of actions. Through this experience, I was able to conclude a better understanding of effective teaching methods while broadening my knowledge of dance and rhythm. And I think I nailed it. Kiki, do you love me? Are you riding? Say you never ever leave from beside me, 'cause I want you and I need you, and I'm down for you always. KB, do you love me? Are you riding? Say you never ever leave from beside me. For my last medium, I chose to complete a visual arts component of one-point perspective drawing, in which is based upon drawing from the vanishing point in which the horizon line is. This type of drawing is great and very structural as you are constantly using a ruler and eraser. However, as an educator and a past student, art for me is not structural, nor is it perfect. It is what you feel, see, and understand from the image or the colors or lines. Art is an important aspect of mental growth. It allows students to become open-minded and flexible thinkers, giving them the opportunity to develop their own meaning of the world around them. Thus, in addition to my philosophy of art, I decided to change my approach of what is considered to be perfectly structured and neat to something called an expressionist artwork, where I am able to express my mood through different dimensions. Nonetheless, creative arts is nothing but an avenue for success within education. Implementation of creative arts will transform students to become more engaged within areas of study and gain sufficient skills. Within my experience, I have completed the 2.1 and 3.4 Australian professional standards for teachers, thus leading me towards professional learning strategies that will enable me to conduct more enriched lessons in the near future.